Huh, looks like Emmett's been busy.
Pardon me, sir. From the way you're dressed and your general aura of seediness, I can infer only one thing. You're heading for Tannen's Speakeasy. Am I right?
Yeah. Can't you tell me the way?
Down. Straight down. The last stop before the Inferno. Unfortunately, I don't have the power to stop you, but I beg you to tarry here a few more seconds and listen to my song. Me, 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 me. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. What in heaven's name?
Oh, sorry, Miss Strickland. Just a little experimental prototype gone momentarily awry.
Mr. Brown, why is there a dog in that vehicle?
Why? Well, to advance the human condition, of course. Hello, Harry.
Harry? Mr. Callahan, what are you doing in that getup?
I'm going undercover.
How exciting! You'll have to give me an exclusive sometime. Right now, I've got some souls to save.
And you'll have to get an eyeful of my newest experiment.
You're not angry about the rocket drill?
Water over the bridge. I've moved on to bigger and better things. Come by the gazebo when you get a chance. I'll be setting up. You won't believe what Einie and I have been up to.
Famous last words. All right. Now, where's that speakeasy? Donate to the Clock Tower Fund. What's wrong with the clock tower? It's not broken, is it?
Not in the slightest.
Whew.
It's just painfully drab. I'm raising funds to commission a sculptor to place a couple of handsome ornamental statues on either side of the clock face. Something to inspire the citizens to do their civic duty.
Something like lions?
Or gargoyles. You can't beat a good gargoyle.
What's all this?
These are my pamphlets, laying out in scientific detail the horrors visited upon those who succumb to the temptations of alcohol.
Lost Fortnight.
I am particularly fond of that one. It tells the true life tale of Johnny, who woke up in a pile of his own sick, completely unable to remember the previous 2 weeks of his life.
Heavy.
Actually, the pamphlets are quite light. See?
Who sent you?
Ulysses S. Grant.
What did you bring me?
Meat and potatoes.
What's the word?
Words are for wimps.
Ew.
Who died and made you boss?
Hieronymus Bosch?
Take a hike, squirt. Who is the king of Siam?
Am I?
What will you do if there's a raid?
Radio for help?
Where did you come from?
From Russia, with love.
Welcome to L Kids, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to once again present the hottest little number this side of the Rockies. And when I say my pleasure, I think y'all know what I'm talking about. Am I right? So let's have a big L Kid welcome for the one, the only, Trixie Trotter.
got no sense, but I don't care. They may or may not mean offense, but I don't care.
Out of my way, kid. I got some sorrows to drown.
I am my own superintendent. My star is on the ascendant. That's why I don't care. I don't care. I don't care what people think of me. I'm happy, go lucky.
El Kid, I still don't get it.
It's like that El Cid place down in L.A., only it's El Kid.
Ah, okay, I see.
I don't care if I do get the mean and stony stare. If I never successful,
hey, you!
You talking to me?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Oh, lay off, Ernie. He's kind of cute.
You think you can just waltz in here and make a play for another fella's girl?
Maybe. What are you gonna do about it, chicken?
That's it! You're toast!
Looks like you need to cool off for a few.
Way down in Louisiana, down in New Orleans. Maybe not.
Hey, I do the singing round here.
Sorry, lady. I didn't mean to get your boyfriend kicked out of the club.
Oh, water under the bridge. You want to keep his seat warm?
Thanks anyway. I don't care. It's the lyrics to her song. Excuse me. Are you Trixie Trotter?
That's what it says on my dressing room door. At least, it would if I had a dressing room.
What's a nice gal like you doing with a guy like Tannen?
Oh, kid ain't so bad. He just takes some...
Hey, Dutz, any chance you could sing that can-can number? The guys really love the way it shows off your, assets.
Whatever you say, kid.
And quit lazing around. I ain't paying you to yak with the drunks.
You ain't paying me at all, you bum. What were we talking about again?
You were telling me what a great guy Kid is.
Yeah, I guess he is a pretty crummy boyfriend. But until my insurance policy checks out, I guess I'm stuck with him.
Insurance?
Yeah. Look, I may not be the brightest bulb in the marquee, but even I know. You don't break up with a creep like Kid without something to keep him from going all crazy on you.
What's this insurance policy all about?
Are you kidding? There's only one person I trust with my secrets. But I ain't seen him in weeks.
You don't mean...
Artie McFly.
Artie McFly.
You know him?
Not as well as I thought.
Before he took a powder, Artie was tutoring me in all sorts of stuff. Etiquette, philosophy, accounting... He's a regular Renaissance man. He even had one of those smart guy professor's pipes, see?
Can I borrow this?
Sure. I've been secretly working on my get-out-of-kid card for weeks now, but Artie's the only one I trust to check my work. You can't be too careful when you're dealing with a maniac like Kid, you know.
I really like your voice.
Thanks. You should hear me when I ain't so under the weather.
You're sick?
Oh, yeah. Sore throat. That's why I'm giving Cueball so many extended solos tonight.
I kind of wondered about that. Do you know Sister Christian?
I don't do religious tunes.
I don't care. What are those? Are they lyrics for one of your songs?
I haven't memorized them yet.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
She's supposed to turn on Kid Tannen tonight? Okay, Doc, if you say so. Hey, I know you. You're...
Parker. Osfer, Danny Parker. Hill Valley PD. Have we met? You look familiar.
Nah.
Well, stranger, sit down and have a drink on me.
I hear you've been having troubles.
Troubles? Buddy, nobody knows the troubles I've seen.
Want to talk about them?
Do I? Do I? Yeah, I do. Listen, it all started when this car...
Every morning, every evening, paint we got fun. Not much money, oh, but honey, paint we got fun.
Whoopee!
Yeah, now about those troubles...
I don't want to wallow in misery. I came here to get happy. Hallelujah!
In the winter, in the summer, don't we have fun? Times are bum and getting bummer, still we have fun. There's nothing surer. The rich get rich and the poor get children.
Shouldn't you be arresting Tannen?
For what?
Well, for running a speakeasy, for one thing.
Well, I like this speakeasy. So there. Besides, if I arrested him, I'd have to arrest you and me and everyone else in here. And that's just way too much work for one little cop like me.
Should you be drinking so much on duty?
Probably not, but this joint ain't open when I'm off duty.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
I'm supposed to get this guy to arrest Kid Tannen tonight? Louis the Louse, squashed in his prime. Hey, bartender.
What'll it be?
I'll have a drink.
What's your poison?
On second thought, forget it.
Suit yourself.
So about this, portrait gallery of yours.
What about it?
What's it all about? Who are those guys?
The caricatures hanging along the wall of honor commemorate those who are no longer with us on account of having ticked off one Irving Kid Tannen.
They're the guys the kids killed?
Well, of course not. They're just a bunch of guys that Kid didn't particularly like and that at a later date turned up dead. It's a circumstantial coincidence. Yeah.
What are you drawing?
Another celebrity caricature.
You drew those?
Prohibition ain't gonna last forever, bub. I gotta have a skill I can fall back on when all this goes away.
Thanks for the talk.
Next time, order a drink. This ain't no library, you know.
You think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly fink.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears? Should I come back for it?
Suit yourself.
Hey, nice suit. Where'd you get it?
Costume shop at the mall. I had it custom made.
Yeah? Quality material. Who are you? Where you from?
Name's, Harry Callahan. I'm one of you guys. Don't you recognize me?
No.
Come on. What's the dope?
Spill it, or I'll...
Go easy, kid. From the cut of the suit, I'm thinking he might be with the Valenti gang.
Is that so?
Yes?
Prove it. You ain't leaving till you show me some bona fides.
I've got a little something here that might convince you.
Don't even blink.
It's not a real gun. It's not a real gun, I swear. It's a gift from Don Valenti. See?
To your family from mine, in gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti.
Looks like little Harry Callahan here really is with the Sacramento boys.
You got stones, Pee-wee. I like that. Have yourself a drink. On the house. Matches. Put down your gun. You look like a moron.
party!
He's back. Any luck driving away Tana's customers with this stuff?
Not really. On nights like this, I fear that nothing will save Hill Valley from descending into the fires of chaos and corruption.
Hey, Edna.
Mr. Callahan, what can I do for you?
What's going on with you and Emmett? The last time I saw you, you seemed to be kind of interested in him.
That was before I belatedly realized that his agreement to host my Stay Sober Society was a clever ruse to ferry barrels of hooch to his so-called laboratory.
Sorry about that.
Now his very presence fills me with an irrepressible urge to pick at his philosophical and intellectual foundations with every tool in my vocabulary.
So you're not dating?
Dating? The mere thought of romantic involvement with that undisciplined techno-anarchist is preposterous.
Good. What are you doing out here in the middle of the night?
Saving people from alcohol, vice, and disorder. And also keeping a lookout for hot stories. You'd be surprised how much news breaks on this corner.
What was that song you were singing earlier?
Do you like it? I wrote it myself. It really gets the toes tapping at the Stay Sober Society meetings. Although I suppose that could be the shakes. Would you like to hear it again?
Sure.
I knew if I waited long enough, somebody would request it. You say you've lost your self-respect, but you should care. It's not too late to redirect and start to care. Don't despise the good and pure. Time to rise up from the sewer. Wash off all that foul manure. Show the world you care. You should care. You should care. What people think of you. Of goals that you could name. Reclaiming your good name is what you ought to do. You should care. You should care. If your reputation is in disrepair, it's not going to hurt you to reclaim your virtue, for you should care.
Catchy.
You really think so?
Yeah, it's got a good hook to it.
One needs a good hook if one is fishing for souls.
Do you think I could have a copy of your You Should Care lyrics? I've got a club of my own that could really use some inspiring.
Sure. Let me just get a page out of the hymnal. There you are.
Hey, thanks. See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Harry, you're just in time.
Have you been, Emmett? I know I haven't seen you in a couple of months.
I'm great, and I owe it all to you.
Really?
Yes. That argument I had with my father during our jet drill experiment gave me the incentive to finally quit that dreary court job. I've committed myself full-time to a life of science.
So, thanks for watching Einstein while I've been away.
It's been a pleasure. He's proven to be a surprisingly willing test subject. Almost as if he's been working with me for years.
More like decades. What's the story with the little car and all this equipment?
Einstein and I are conducting a few experiments with this one-quarter scale model to work out a few hitches in my planned demonstration at the Hill Valley Expo in a couple of months.
A radio-controlled car?
No. Well, yes, but it'll be so much more than that. It will amaze the world. Aha! Got it!
Got what?
I'll show you. Ready to go, Einstein? Watch this! When this baby hits 23 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious cow flop.
Einstein!
No!
Get him out of there!
Not to worry. I've got a fail-safe eject mechanism around here someplace. See? Nothing to worry about.
Nothing. I'll go see if I can find something to help. Or someone. Don't worry, Emmett. I'm sure you'll get it right someday.
Oh, I'm not worried about that. Right now, I'm more concerned with Einstein.
What went wrong with your rocket car?
I'm not entirely sure. As soon as we get Einstein down, I'm gonna go look for it.
Can't you just go into the courthouse to get Einstein?
If I still had my job as a clerk, sure, but lately a lot of evidence has gone missing, so they've installed new locks. Now the place is sealed up tighter than my dad's wallet.
Well, I'll go off and see if I can get some help.
You do that. I'll stay here and see if I can think of a way to get Einie off that ledge.
Hill Valley Expo, October 12th through the 15th. Doc says the expo was the day he officially became a scientist. Seems like he's running a couple months ahead of schedule. Majestic Arms. Transients welcome. Well, they don't get more transient than me and Doc. Hey, Doc. How's the room?
It's a little cleaner than I would have imagined for a Depression-era flophouse. How are your investigations going?
I saw him.
Who?
My grandpa, on his streetcar for just a second. Doc, we gotta find him.
Why?
Trixie thinks she's got something that could put Kid away, but Artie's the only one who can tell her for sure. I guess he's kind of her tutor or something.
Ah, so that's the connection. When your grandfather disappeared from Hill Valley for 2 months, the bond between him and Miss Trotter was severed, eventually leading to a timeline in which Trixie lost the nerve to betray Tannen.
Yeah?
We've got to find your grandfather.
Where'd you park the DeLorean?
I hid it in the DeSoto lot. Nobody's buying cars these days, so it should be safe in there.
Why didn't you tell me I'd run into your younger self tonight?
Because I don't remember being out here tonight. Clearly, your interactions with my younger self 2 months ago have slightly altered my personal timeline. I never have the nerve to perform public experiments like he's doing. No matter. Those experiments will be forgotten once I've seen Frankenstein.
Frankenstein?
Yes. Right now, my younger self is fiddling around out there with rocket propulsion systems for his demonstration at the expo.
The thing that'll kick off your scientific career.
Exactly. Now, the rockets are a horrible idea, and I'll soon realize that they'll never work. But eventually, I'll wander into that movie theater and see Frankenstein and clear my mind. I've kept the ticket stub from that movie in my wallet ever since. See?
Why?
Because it's during this movie that I'll have the inspiration for my breakthrough at the expo.
It doesn't have anything to do with reanimating the dead, does it?
Not the way you're thinking, no. But during that famous scene when Colin Clive turned the wheel that raised that shrouded figure into the tower, and that bolt of lightning struck, well, let's just say more than one brain was reanimated that night.
Emmett's not having much luck getting Einstein off the courthouse.
I'm not surprised. Einie's a smart dog, but heights give him the willies.
What can we do?
I've got it.
What?
Just get my younger self distracted, and I'll handle the rest.
Okay, I better get back to fixing history.
Be careful, Marty.
Edna!
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh, what is it?
Young scientist strands dog on courthouse roof.
What?
Look over there.
Oh, for goodness sake. Mr. Brown!
Please, Miss Strickland, not now. Can't you see I've got a rather delicate situation on my hands at the moment? My trial run...
Trial run? Public hazard, I call it. And I'm sure my editor will agree. This scientific enterprise of yours represents a clear and present danger to public
safety.
You
know what represents a clear and present danger to public safety? Your singing voice.
There's no need to get personal, Mr. Brown.
Believe me, I have no intention of getting personal with you.
I'm relieved to hear it. Flying cars, of all the ridiculous juvenile notions.
You mock me, but just imagine, a world in which traffic jams and car crashes are a thing of the past.
I might be more inclined to listen to you if your maiden voyage hadn't ended in a crash on one roof and a stranded dog on another.
I'm working on getting him down. Einie, how'd you get down? Clever dog.
Well, fortune favors you tonight, but I warn you to be more careful in the future.
Now, how to get that rocket car back down?
Hey, boy, take a whiff of this. Gotta love that nose.
I've been laying low, officer, but I've gotta go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But...
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good. Don't think it would go there. Don't think it would go there. Don't think it would go there. Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Just stay back here in the shadows and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Hey, Trixie, look over there!
Why?
Didn't you see it?
No.
Ah, never mind. Danny.
You!
So about those troubles.
I really care what you think of me. If I told you about my troubles, you might think I was a crybaby.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
Way down in Louisiana, down in New Orleans. Maybe not.
Hey, I do the singing round here.
Trixie?
Yeah?
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
to... Cover for me, cue ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you?
I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate.
All right, fella. I think you're done for the night. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you. What do you know about this?
Nothing. I...
Ah!
Trixie?
Break's over, cue ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that? Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid!
Well, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this.
So, I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head. Which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then...
What?
Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live.
Huh?
Seriously, down on the knees crying and begging for McFly's life.
So, what did you do?
What could I do? I fired two shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
I guess that's Grandpa's nose blood.
Welcome back, sir.
Voila!
Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
You in?
Why not? Something tells me Black's gonna hit.
Seven.
Damn. Sorry about this, Dad. Trixie?
Yeah?
I talked to Kid.
Oh?
He told me about Artie.
Oh.
It was awesome of you to plead for his life.
And it was awesome of Kid to spare it. So you see why I gotta get rid of all the dirt I got on Kid. As long as he's loyal to me, I gotta stay loyal to him.
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of Kid's books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper! He's not interested. Figures. Half the police force is in Tannen's pocket.
Give me a few minutes to work on him. I've got a hunch he'll come around.
Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
Danny.
You.
So about those troubles.
I really care what you think of me. If I told you about my troubles, you might think I was a crybaby.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
Hey.
Back off, Kid. I'm trying to entertain some people here.
Come to me, my melancholy baby. Cuddle up and don't be blue. All your fears are foolish, fancy, maybe. You know, dear,
Danny,
I'm in love
with you.
So about those troubles.
It all started on June 14th, I was chasing down one of Tannen's boys when this car, straight out of Buck Rogers, popped up out of nowhere and ran my car off the road.
No.
Then later, I lost track of a witness. The poor schlub hasn't been heard from since.
That wasn't your fault.
And then, to top it off, I somehow managed to lose custody of an 80-year-old arsonist. When not one, but two of those godforsaken space cars showed up and whisked him away.
That's unbelievable.
That's what the chief said. Demoted me on the spot. My family sent me to a psychiatrist because they thought I was seeing things. And worst of all, my gal Betty left me because she thinks I'm a bad provider and a head case.
Betty? As in Jennifer's grandma Betty?
What?
Listen, Danny, it's really important that you get back together with Betty.
Oh, that ship sailed. What the heck with her?
I got a little secret that'll set me up with women twice as classy as Betty'll ever be.
See you later, Danny.
I'll be here.
Got a secret? What is it?
Oh, yeah. My secret. Well, you're my pal, so I can tell you. But don't let it get out. I've been working for Tannen for over a month now.
What?
It's true. All I gotta do is look the other way while evidence is getting destroyed or a truck full of gin is coming across the county line. And Tannen made sure an extra bunch of bills makes their way into my pay envelope. Great deal, huh?
Just whisper, whisper, whisper in my ear.
No, not a great deal.
What's the problem? People need to drink, right? As long as no one's getting hurt, why shouldn't Daniel J. Parker make a few bucks on the action?
But people are getting hurt. Kid's a killer.
Ah, that's just rumors and circumnavigational evidence. Although, that wall of fame is pretty spooky. Oh, God. I've made a horrible mistake. I thought if I could get my hands on some money, that Betty'd take me back. But when she finds out what I'd done, she'll never even talk to me again. What have I done?
Come on, Danny. Pull yourself together. It's not so bad.
Not so bad? I'm a corrupt cop who's lost his only chance at true love. How's that not so bad?
Hang in there, Danny.
Oh, God. Right. I can turn my life around.
Sure you can.
You know what? I used to be a good cop. And yeah, I've had a few bad breaks. Possibly even a psychotic one that caused me to imagine a disappearing space car. But I'm a good man.
Yeah.
And all I need to do to win Betty back is be the same good man I always was. And let the chips fall where they may.
All right.
Hey, Miss Trotter, you wanted to speak with me?
What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville.
Yeah, but in the meantime...
All right, everyone, party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy?
You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Callahan. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
I don't know. The Valenti mob doesn't like being associated with losers.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually. Hey, boy, how you doing? Good dog. There's only a few people, and maybe an animal or two, who'd be interested in Grandpa's smelly old pipe. But this isn't one of them. Parker must have confiscated this hooch from the speakeasy. Irving, Kid, Tannen. I guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures. Hey, Einie, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie. Okay, I'll check it out. Button. It's empty, so what's the point? All right, Doc, here I come.
Callahan, what are you doing here?
Never mind.
Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker!
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there!
Watch out!
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
It's locked. I can't reach them from over here. Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat!
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen!
Whoa!
Bowling for Tannens. I can't get to the car from here.
No one messes with Kid Tannen!
my kid!
Lead, phony!
Hey, moron!
Moron, this!
Go, Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat! Hey!
Atta girl.
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
So...
I'm afraid I'm finding it difficult to concentrate with all the bullets flying around my head, Mr. Callahan.
Right.
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
Hey, kid!
That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Hey, he's getting away!
Oh, no.
Yes. No. There! Good as new.
Oh, look,
Tannen.
The judge's son. All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Doc.
Marty.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Great Scott!
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I...
You! Emmett! You're the cause of all of this, ain't you? Should have known. You don't look like any Callahan I ever seen.
Yeah, well, what kind of gangster's named Irving?
Hey!
Doc, hit it!
What the hell?
Woohoo!
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Thanks for letting me fly the DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
Are you absolutely sure that everything's back to normal?
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Do you feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Emmett and Edna. They're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd. Great Scott!
What?
We've got to get back in. Something horrible. This could be disastrous.
Stop! Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax! We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown. It's not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?